In this lecture, we are going to learn iterative constructs, that is, looping structures in VB.NET. First, let us understand what is a loop. A loop is said to be the set of instructions which are repeated again and again in a program. In a program, there can be a set of statements which we need to execute repeatedly. So this process of executing a block of statements repeatedly until the given condition is true is called as looping or iteration. A loop statement allows us to execute a statement or group of statements multiple times. This is the general form used by most of the programming languages for executing a group of statements multiple times. So here the looping statement checks for the condition. If the condition is true, a statement or block of statement gets executed. After execution, the condition is checked. If condition is true, the block is repeated. This process continues till the condition is true. When the condition becomes false, it terminates the loop and it goes to the next statement. This is how loop statement works. Let us understand various types of looping structures available in VB.NET. So there are three types we are going to learn in this lecture. First is for next, then we have do while loop, and third we have is while end while. Let us understand these statements one by one. For next statement. This type of statement is used when the user knows in advance how many times the loop is going to be executed. And accordingly, the loop statement is designed. This is the syntax followed by the for next statement. It starts with for counter variable equal to start value to end value, step increment or decrement value. It ends with the next counter variable. Between for and next, here one statement or a block of statements which are to be executed multiple times are added. Counter variable is initialized with the start value and it keeps track of how many times the loop has executed. When the counter variable reaches the end value, the loop is terminated. And at every iteration, the counter variable value will be incremented or decremented as specified here. Let us see one example. The first example is generate natural numbers from 1 to 100 using for next statement. The code which we need to design using for next statement is for I equal to 1 to 100 list box 1 dot items dot add I next I. So here I is the counter variable which is initialized with the value 1. Here we have used list box control in which the values can be added, and this can be done with the property items. Items.add will add the value of I in the list box. As the step value is not mentioned, by default I is incremented by 1 every time. Let us understand how it executes. First, I is initialized to 1. It is added into the list box. Next, I will increment the value of I by 1, so it becomes 2. 2 is added into the list box. I is incremented by 1, it becomes 3. 3 is added. This is repeated till I is 100. After adding 100 into the list box, when it reaches next I, it becomes 101. When I becomes 101, the loop is terminated. Let us take one more example to generate first 20 even numbers. So the code required for this is, for e equal to 2240, step 2, list box 1 dot items dot add e, next e. So here e is initialized to 2. 2 is added into the list box. As step value mentioned is 2, the value of e will be incremented by 2. It becomes 4. 4 is less than 40, that is, it has not reached 40. So 4 is added. Next, e will increment e by 2. It becomes 6. 6 is added. And this process continues up to 40. When e becomes 42, the loop terminates, and in the list box, the first 20 numbers are added. This is how for next statement works. Next statement is do while loop. This statement executes the statements specified in the body of the loop till the condition evaluates to true. The loop may not be executed at all if the condition is initially false. So here, do while syntax is do while condition or boolean expression. One or more VB statements and loop. If the condition is true, it executes this block of statements. Once the condition becomes false, the loop is terminated. Suppose initially, if the condition is false, it will not execute this block of statements. Let us understand the working of do while loop with one example. So this example is to display GCC 5 times. The code we require is I equal to 1, do while I less than or equal to 5, this is the condition, list box 1 dot items dot add GCC. As it is the text value, it is enclosed in double quotes. I value is incremented by using I equal to I plus 1, and the loop ends with the keyword loop. First, I value is initialized to 1. It checks the condition 1 less than 5. condition is true, it enters the block and GCC is added into the list box. When it goes to the next statement, I equal to I plus 1, it increments the value of I by 1, I becomes 2, it checks the condition 2 is less than 5, GCC is added for the second time, I is incremented by 1, I becomes 3, condition is true, again GCC is printed and this process continues for 5 times. When I reaches 6, it terminates the loop. This is how do while loop works. Next statement we have is while end while. It executes a series of statements as long as a given condition is true. When condition becomes false, it stops the execution of the loop. The syntax here is while condition one or more VB statements which are to be repeated end while. Let us understand this with one example. The same example we have taken here to display GCC 5 times. I is initialized to 1. The syntax is while condition. As we need to print GCC 5 times, the condition required is I less than or equal to 5. List box 1 dot items dot add GCC. I equal to I plus 1. End while. So the working of while end while statement is same as the do while loop. I is initialized to 1, condition is tested, if condition is true the block gets executed, so GCC will be added. I is incremented, it becomes 2, condition is true, 2 is less than 5, so GCC is added into the list box and this process continues up to I equal to 5. When I reaches 6, it terminates the loop.